up your game now. I'm your SI dude.
Look, I might be totally off the cart here, and she might generally be friends with Steve because she found a connection with him straight away.
No, I don't.
But
think
I don't.
Dude, why was she connected with Steve? Why was she
connected? She was only here 5 minutes, and she you could tell who she puts effort in with,
yeah.
And who she. And I don't believe if I didn't talk to her, I would have probably no connection with her whatsoever.
Yeah,
I'm not. To be honest, I'm not really that interested in talking to her.
Hmm.
And but you could tell, like, she'll chase after certain people. She'll say, oh, like, there's a reason for that. And it ain't because she feels as though she's got more confidence. She knows out there what the deal is. And she feels as though she can, if she can smooth over the Baron and get on the Baron's side, she will join him on the way to the top. Personally, I hope, I hope to God that it backfires.
Yeah.
It's one thing to play the game.
Yeah.
And it's another thing to use people and to fuck with people's emotions. That is fucking wrong.
The Baron isn't being sucked in by none of this. The Baron is fully aware of what's going on.
Oh, the Baron fucking likes stupid. Don't worry about that.
He knows what the crack is.
Oh, he fucking knows. Don't worry about that. He's always known. He fucking knows the deal.
John James, could you show Big Brother what's on your leg?
Six 16 PM. For today's task, housemates will be paired up against each other in a pantyhose tug of war. As the adjudicator, Steve has chosen who'll be competing in each pair based on their size, height and weight. Kiva will face Keely.
I reckon I'll win this, by the way, if I'm up with you, Keeve.
Do you?
Hey.
Just letting you know.
Keith, make sure you win.
But they're being in a power of
John James,
I'm a turtle neck.
White beater
to V-neck. Keeper, what? You make sure you don't pull off my eyelashes?
No. I'm going straight for them.
I know that's what I'm trying to leave on my eyelashes.
That's the spirit.
The fighting spirit.
Walking back to happiness.
One bye, oh yeah, yeah. I said goodbye to loneliness. One bye, oh yeah, yeah.
Look, you fought this little battle between the Mad Irish
and Betty.
Polly Pocket.
Yeah, same, yeah. I hope she fucking flings her over the fucking fence. I really do. Oh, she fucking flies over.
She's feisty, man.
Yeah, set me off dinner time.
Hey?
Fucking bitch face.
Who?
Her.
Why?
Because she goes in, I have a real feeling I'm going to win this. I was like, fuck you, bitch.
Yeah, eh?
Hey, cockiness.
Six 41 PM. For today's task, housemates must go head to head in a tug of war using a pair of tights worn over their heads. If the tights split or are pulled off the head of a housemate, that housemate will lose. The winners of each bout will attend a pampering party later this evening.
This is Big Brother. Would Steve announce which housemates will take part in the first round?
Yeah, the first housemates in the first round will be John against Mario.
You look so funny.
Steve, will you shout who wins?
Yeah.
Get ready, guys.
I'm nervous. Are you nervous?
Tights off his head.
I'm still holding on to it though.
Mario loses, John wins.
Fuck's sake! Oh.
Hey, what happened?
That's why you have to hold him over you, under your chin.
This is Big Brother. John James, you're the winner. You should put on a winner's badge and sit down on the winner's bench.
Was there any evidence?
Mario, you're a loser.
The lucky man.
You should put on a loser's badge and sit
there.
Down on the loser's bench.
I'll sit where I want.
So loser, so loser.
Get your badge, John. Mario. Come over here, stop sulking.
Come on, man.
Don't make yourself look like a bad loser.
It would have to have broke my neck to get that off.
Oh, I don't care. Mario. Come on, can we get on with this?
Next round will be Rachel and Corinne. In the next round, we're going to have Dave the Monk against Ben Jeminja.
I feel like a burglar.
Dave wins. Josie against Andrew. Stay there.
Don't look like a bank robber.
No, screw that.
I didn't have a chance, Andrew. You don't understand. I can smell a gusset.
Kiva and Keely.
Seven twenty-seven p.m.
Yeah, well, Mario Judy popped, didn't he?
But more than that, but it's just everyone's now noticing of what I've had put up with for about 3 weeks. Yeah. Yes, he is a nice guy and he's everyone's friend, but by God, he's a spoilt brat. He's a bad loser
as
well.
He's a bad loser.
I mean, it's just pathetic. One of his big bugbears with me is that he'll be saying something and then someone else will come up to me and I'll start talking to them. But I'm not being nasty, but he's boring, you know? Yeah. I might not be athletic, but at least I've got the odd story to tell. Hmm. You know, if you know, he wants to be the best in every field and you just can't be.
Big Brother has called John James and Josie to the diary room.
John James and Josie, yesterday morning you both broke Big Brother rules by turning off your microphones.
Piss off, I did not.
Don't fucking blame it all on me, Tom.
You turn off my mic.
Oh, shut up! Don't you can't blame it all on me.
When?
Just take some responsibility, folks.
When did you turn off my mic?
In Josie's hand is a piece of paper with a sentence written on it. The sentence reads, I must not switch off my microphone. You must each write that sentence 10 times on each other's body, avoiding the eyes and mouth.
What? But I didn't turn off my mic. You know I didn't turn off my mic. Oh, this is bullshit.
Aye, naughty boy John.
Oh, you're making it big
Shall
enough.
Shall I put I naughty boy John? Or
no, no, you just write write the sentence.
All right.
Do you have to do the eyes like that? Is there a need for the extra lines on the eyes?
Because that's how it's rare. You know, I can't help the way I write, John.
I was just annoyed that we didn't actually get to complete it to see who would actually...
Oh, you were annoyed, were you, at the time?
Yeah.